This is KTVO's Good Morning Heartland.
Good morning, Heartland, and thanks for joining us this morning. I'm Ella Soroka.
And I'm Troy Mullen.
Well, today is Tuesday, September 2nd. So hopefully
sure is.
You all are rested and ready to get back to the grind, you know, because for some, it's a four-day work week.
Mm-hmm.
For others, it's just
for others, it's not. Who knows? Maybe for some, it's a three-day week. Maybe
yeah.
They're like, eh, I'm not going back today.
Yeah,
so.
You know, but it is what it is. Yesterday was Labor Day. Hopefully you enjoyed it, whether you went to an outdoor festivity, had your own little barbecue, or if you worked, you are...
And if you were in labor yesterday, it was... Doubly special for you.
I wonder how many people had babies on Labor Day.
I wonder how many women were due maybe mid-August, but they're like, keep this thing in me. I want to have this baby on Labor Day.
I doubt it.
Not so much?
There's no woman alive who wants to hang on any longer.
Lisa just said there is no woman alive on Earth that would want to just hold on just a little longer.
I'll take her word for it.
I would take her word for it, too. So, anyways, I see that you are wearing white. I am wearing white. We have broken
the fashion police
the fashion
will be busting in any moment now.
Do not wear white after Labor Day, but I have made it my mission to wear white all this week. And I had said earlier that I kind of didn't plan out this plan really well because I was lazy, so I didn't want to iron this morning when I woke up. So I just grabbed this dress because I don't have to iron it. But then I have three white shirts that I can wear, but they're all, like, similar.
Yeah.
And I don't want people thinking I'm wearing the same white shirt.
Yeah, I know what you mean, similar white shirts.
Yeah.
I know what you mean by that.
So,
well, no, that's why I said just put bleach in with the wash, and you'll have a ton of white clothes.
Yeah. Or, you know.
Problem solved. That's what I do.
I'll wear some white pants maybe one day. We'll see. I'll make it work. Or I'll wear the same thing over and over every day this week. You'll have to tune in to find out.
I like that idea, too.
Okay, so before we reveal what our national day is, we do have a huge announcement to make, and the huge announcement is that we have 10 lucky winners of our Visa gift card giveaway. You are $50 richer.
Do I need to get my instrument
No,
ready?
It's okay. Now, we'll just say congratulations to you. Are you ready? Heather Brumbaugh, Sandy Muir, Stormy Cole, Brenda King, Danita Gordon, Sue Morton, Rusty Beeler, Jody Campbell-Chambers, Tammy Lee, and Dana Weber. Congratulations. Our team will be contacting you via email to let you know when you can come and pick up your $50 back to school Visa gift card.
Tammy Lee, that's the drummer from Motley Crue, right?
No, that's Tommy.
Tommy Lee.
Lee.
I know, I'm just
Would you like to know what National Day it is?
Of course.
It is National Write in Cursive Day.
Ooh, I used to have really good penmanship, cursive penmanship. Now I don't.
Until you
even,
got older.
Yeah, now.
Do you write in cursive or do you write
Well, that's
in print?
One reason I write so rarely now because just always typing things out that. Mm-hmm. I guess I've kind of lost my certain je ne sais quoi that made my penmanship so special back in the day.
Is cursive still required in schools
it
these
should
days?
Be. It should be.
Yes, it in some be. Schools. I remember that was in third grade. Is that when you learn? That's when I learned in third grade. We had a period where we learned cursive.
It was third for me as well.
Yeah.
It was.
So.
But I've always loved the cursive W.
Yeah.
So regal. I love it.
I'm trying to think. There's some letters that I don't think I remember how to do in cursive, like the capital ones.
Like which ones? I'll tell you right now. I remember them all.
Q.
Q is, it's almost like a little two. Well, it's backwards for everyone at home. I guess it would be like that.
Right. Show me really quickly.
Okay.
I know lowercase q.
That's a Q. It's almost like a two.
Really?
That's how I've always made it.
No.
Uh-huh. And the little line, well... The line goes down underneath the little tail of it goes down under the line. So where the little tail would be would be underneath the line.
So write quail next to it, so I can see because this does not look right. Really,
my U doesn't look very good. But
I don't know.
That's how I would write quail in cursive.
Is this right? He's right. Okay, you're right. I'm wrong. What's new?
I mean. If you were to do a regular Q and then do the rest in cursive, people would still know what you're talking about, so. Write quail a lot, do you?
What's that?
That's just an ampersand.
Oh, I need to take some glasses. Let's talk about some weather.
Yeah, let's check out the day planner, see what we've got going on. Nothing in cursive, on the day planner today. But this time yesterday, we're tracking the storms, and this morning we can enjoy some very pleasant conditions. Lots of sun in the forecast today. A few clouds to begin your morning, but clearing up nicely. 64 degrees by 7 a.m., and we're looking to be into the upper 70s by noon. This afternoon, 80 degrees. Rain chances less than 10% today, and all in all, a really beautiful day. Coming up over the next 5 days, we really do have something for everyone as far as the temperatures are concerned. Everybody's going to like it. Wait until you see what we have in store. That's just ahead. Ella, back to you.